So is that what you want on the camera, that he's going to support us?
You, whatever you want on your site, man.
You're saying that you're going to support me.
Well, I really can't get the audio because it's too noisy. Just stand together and shake hands.
He'll start it, you know, and then I'll make that the first question.
Is that your brochure?
So he must be a good guy.
Jack Harper.
Who?
Yeah, like Howard's okay.
But you're running the
video. Oh, shut up.
Howard's okay. Okay, Raymond, who are you there with?
I'm here with Sheriff Joe Arpaio. This is...
Does he support you, Raymond?
You support me, Joe?
I've known Ray for many years. Not because he's a pretty good guy. He has a great background. And I think he spent a little time as a private investigator.
Right.
Which means a lot. He knows about life. But one reason I support him is very conservative. Believes in taking care of our kids in school. Small government. And, of course, the illegal immigration. I think his opponent is open borders. And I think that's sad. So we got to get Ray elected and continue to protect the people, not only in his district, but in the state. And as you know, because of the illegal immigration, that's gone national. So it's a bigger problem, not just his district, but affects the whole
country. So, Joe, you're pro illegal immigration, or you're against it? Are you?
There's a lot of semantics about open borders, sometimes you get caught. I don't want to get caught like the general did
and
get fired, but they can't fire me because I'm elected.
I warned some of the people that came here. I said, you know, make sure that you don't have any outstanding warrants when you come here tonight, I says, because Sheriff Joe, he's pretty tough. And I says, I've got a little bit of influence with him, but I don't think I can keep you out of an outstanding warrant. So,
Your Honor, stick your head in.
A lot of people didn't show up, Joe, because of that.
The sheriff.
I get accused by all these open border politicians like the mayor of Phoenix and everybody.
Oh.
I should be going after warrants and not go after poor guards.
Dishwashers.
There's an interim county attorney trying to destroy me and my illegal immigration, but that's another issue I'm here for.
Well, I think he's going to get destroyed in the next election.
Would you like to introduce me to this gentleman? Who is this guy right now?
This is Sheriff Joe.
Oh, it is?
This is one of my oldest friends. He's the one that gave me my first money when I first decided to run. This guy here came up with the first check. And I didn't know whether I was going to run or not. I didn't know whether anybody wanted me. He says, you run. Yeah, here's your check.
Ray, I would ask you, you confuse me now. You got, because I never asked you where you're from. That'd be racist. I got caught a little bit. Are you from New York or Chicago?
No.
Massachusetts.
I'm from Massachusetts.
Oh, my home.
Yeah.
What part?
I was born in Morris, grew up in Haverhill.
Oh, Haverhill.
Yeah. My brother, I sent him an invitation to this thing, and he said to me, he says, well, he says, I'll tell you what, he says, I almost came down to see Sheriff Joe. I says, what about me? I says, I'm your brother. He says, yeah, but you ain't Sheriff Joe. So,
but I was born and raised in Springfield,
Mass. Out west.
But I live in Boston. I was head of the Federal Drug Enforcement.
Yeah.
But I live in Acton near Lexington, Concord.
Right.
74 to 78.
Wow. I was born there in 36.
Oh, you're a young guy.
Yeah.
And thank you, Joe, for sending me a personalized letter thanking me for supporting you. You do sign letters. and send it to the public for supporting, so which I thought was very honorable.
So you were nice enough to donate to my campaign.
I wrote two letters. I called
you. Well, you just wrote letters. Just think if you put $10.
Hold this a minute.
What's that?
Can you hold on to this?
Back.
Sure.
Get a little guy holding.
So that's to tell you that Sheriff Joe is he's not giving up the sheriff's office to run for governor, and I want to tell you right there, I think you've saved Maricopa County with this decision. I think you really have.
Well, I could have been the governor, but we got to rely on good legislatures because you carry the ball. I do know that the legislature that passed that 1070, you seem to get lost in the shuffle.
Yeah.
I know someone did sign it,
yeah.
But you can't sign
it. He's taking a lot of credit for it.
Yeah, I don't think you can sign it if the legislature. So,
Why don't you sit down, Howard?
Very well prepared. I want to go ahead and see if you got
it.
I don't know if you need an introduction anymore.
He's a hard-working guy. You're lucky to have him, right? And, he's from Massachusetts. He's going to school in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
We're all Massachusetts.
We click.
Yeah. We won't hold that against you.
Right? I don't know how Republicans from Mass showed up here. But I've known Ray for many, many years. He's a good guy. Did a lot of work at the legislature. And now we have to keep him there, but switch over to the other building, which is the Senate. And we need guys like him in the Senate because we have a lot of problems ahead. And everybody gives the governor, I'm not going to badmouth the governor, but everybody gives her all the credit. But you have to understand, it's the legislature that makes the laws. Without the legislature, governor can't sign nothing. So that's why it's critical to have good people. Conservative people in the legislature. I know everybody talks about illegal immigration, the 1070. I could go on and on. I get a little concerned because I talk about it, but there's other issues too, not just illegal immigration. And Ray understands that. He's not a one-issue guy, although it's important. One reason I'm supporting Ray is I don't like his opponent. Because that opponent probably should have a D in front of her name, and, which is okay because the guy that just hates me is a Democrat.
I didn't say that, but I don't disagree with you.
I think we need some conservative people, especially this time that we're living with the budget, illegal immigration, and so I just hope you. Spread the word. I tried to do it. I'm sorry I introduced you to one of my enemies. But fortunately, he's a Democrat. He can't vote for you in the primary. He's a union guy for the police. And this guy, first time I met him as a person, I tell it like it is. And I think that's what people want today, is some people tell it like it is, even though you may not agree with them. But at least you get what you get. There's just too many politicians that had to fend his fundraiser. It's true.
I wouldn't fit in.
That's Terry's car?
All right, well, I'll try again.
Terry, I'm not following you around. I saw a car that says Terry Goddard and Obama's. Hang on, yeah. Please, these of us.